Warning, this video may not be suitable for children under the age of 13 or any lame ass. This video contains pure awesomeness and a lot of cussing. If you do not like that, then you can fuck off. You've been warned. So I got this figure in, you guys, this vinyl toy from Violence Toys, the Yowie, and this is like a Sasquatch, Bigfoot looking character. I bought him in a flesh tone. It's going to be a big project for me to paint, and it's going to be a video of me painting this guy. So let's get it started. So first off, of course, you know, with the hair dryer, got to heat up the joints there, because what I'm going to do is I'm going to pop off each individual limb. So it's easier for me to paint. I think most people do this. Once you heat it up, you guys, it should be pretty easy, and they pop off pretty good, pretty easy there, as you can see. And there I am there, getting ready to paint. And yes, I got a mask now. I officially got a mask, not like last time, breathing in that horrible chemical shit. So bought me a mask to be safe, and makes me look cool, in my opinion. What do you guys think? Let me know in the comments, you guys. And yep, here's the vinyl wonder thinner here. That's the first thing you got to do here is prep the figure with this stuff here. So I get this towel, soak it in this thinner, and then I wipe down every individual part. It helps degrease it and gets it ready for me to paint, which is very important step before you're painting. That I learned the hard way. So yep, I do this to everything that I paint, and I'm excited because this is my first like kind of big project that I'm going to paint, and we'll see how it comes out. So let's check it out. So now that it's prepped, you guys, gotta get the paint ready. So I'm gonna use this brown here. This is the main color I'm gonna be using for this Sofubi here. Make sure you guys shake the paint up pretty well, you guys. You want the paint to be even. I also learned this the hard way here. So I usually tap the bottom because it builds up this white. It doesn't show on here, but there, let me show you on another one right here, this green. See how there's this white there? You got to make sure your paint is well mixed, because this is supposed to be like an army green. So so you mix it so there's no longer white in the bottom, and you got to do whatever you got to do. Use a stick, whatever, tapping it, shaking it, do whatever you can, so that way there's no white in the bottom. That's when you know your paint is ready to go. And there it is, it's pretty much done. And so here's my painting process. Got the airbrush here, and just gonna go and spray it and get as much as I can. And this is a new airbrush that I bought. This is a cheap ass one from Harbor Freight. My other one broke literally as I was gonna paint, so luckily I live like two blocks away from a Harbor Freight to buy a cheap ass airbrush. And I'm just practicing, I'm a beginner, so I don't need those big fancy ones. I'm just gonna go on and just paint the rest of this, you guys. You know, get all like the parts that have hair and all that stuff there. So I'm just gonna paint this, you guys, and we'll see how this turns out, you guys. So I'm excited, and so yeah, here it is. So I got the first layer of paint done. As you can see, you can still kind of see the flesh tone underneath that paint. So I'm gonna give it another run, another couple of coats on this paint, and let's see how it turns out. So I gave it a couple coats, you guys, so you can see there. The brown looks a lot better, in my opinion. There's the body there. Still got some more details to do. But I did paint every single individual limbs. And actually came out pretty good. I'm going to get this head, paint the details on the face here. So let's go. So here I'm going to use this white paint. I'm going to use this, I'm going to paint it with a brush here. And I put tape around there so I don't go past, because this paint pretty much is permanent once it's on. And you can see there, got done with the eyes and the scars there. It wasn't pretty easy. Also did the fingernails and the toenails of this guy. And so I used the black and white paint. And now that I'm done painting some of the details there, the smaller stuff here, I'm gonna let the paint dry for a little bit. It takes longer to dry when you use it like that. And that's me saying thumbs up and fuck you. But now that we're done, we're gonna put a clear coat over these bad boys here. Try to get an even coat of clear finish on there. And you just keep spraying and spraying and spraying and spraying. It's a lot, but you just got to do it. And then you do different coats if you want super glossy or if you want less glossy. It's just really up to you and how you're going to want to do this. I kind of like in between. And once I'm done with that, then I kind of just let these guys dry for a few hours just to make sure they are ready to go. Because I'm also going to have to heat them up, put them back together. And this is the final version, you guys. I am fucking finally done. I'm excited. The Yowie Hack'em Figures painted version. And I'm pretty happy in how this turned out. So here he is, you guys. The Yowie by Violence Toys. And I finally finished it. It was like a 2 or 3 week project. More like I just took a whole like 2 or 3 weeks off. It really, it only took me a total maybe like a couple hours to actually really paint the whole thing. But here's a 360 view here, you guys. And I decided to go with a brown color. And thought it came out looking pretty cool. The only thing I don't really like here is the way this came out, his spine. Thought I could have did that a little bit better, but you know, it's trial and error. Just practicing. And I did use, I don't know if you guys can see on the camera, but I did use a little bit of like a green, army green, to look like a kind of like swampy moss kind of color on him. So I did it pretty much everywhere really lightly. Some spots are a little bit darker than others. I don't know if you can see that, but yeah. So we can check out his face here. There, hopefully it's not too blurry, but yep, see that? Painted that. And did this like red with a black, just so that way it looks kind of like it's you know, still kind of injured, you know, not supposed to be blood, but more like a rash kind of look to it. I didn't like how that came out, so I got to figure out another way and how to do that. But you know, trial and error. I'm for sure getting another one if they're still available to paint one. I have an idea of another version of this. So but yeah, so that's him there. And he did come with an accessory, so I got this. It's some kind of animal. It looks like a deer leg. It's not a deer, but I am happy with this. I painted this. I thought this came out pretty cool. You can see like the muscle and the bone there. So I painted that. Thought that looked pretty cool. Pretty cool accessory comes with, you know, was right in his arm there. But that is it, you guys. Thank you guys for checking out my journey and how to paint these Sofubis and airbrushing. It's totally new to me, so I'm just going to keep doing it, keep practicing it. I enjoy it. It's like therapy to me. But that is it, you guys. Thanks for checking out this fucking video. You guys are the shit. And I'll catch you fuckers on the next one. Peace out.